Hello, all you wonderful people out there, and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here checking out this video. If you are a first-time guest, thank you so much for checking out this video. Please come back again, and if you are returning, thank you as well. Today, I'm sharing with you how you can create these special cutout crops of images that you see right here. A while back, I shared a video on how to crop images in Adobe Express, and today I'm walking you through how to create these special ones. So let's go ahead and dive right in. To get started, I'm going to click on the purple plus sign here and choose a custom size graphic. By default, you can just click on next and choose what's already here. You can change it to whatever size you want. For this demo, I'll go ahead and choose next. I'm going to leave it with that white background. And to create this cropped image, first off, let me call this a cutout cropped image. That way I can go back and find it here. And I'm going to find an image that I'm going to use to demonstrate how that cutout, that special cutout looks like. So I'm going to type in here, runner, and I'm going to find one of these photos here. These are the premium photos from Adobe stock. Let's go ahead and go with this runner here. I like the contrast, the yellow and black and white there. And let's go ahead and make this a bit larger so that fills more of the screen and so that you can see it better. Now, what I'll do next is click on the duplicate because I want to create an exact copy of this and not resize it. So I'll keep it here and just kind of move it a little bit to the side. And now with the runner here, this main one, and really it doesn't matter, one of the two, you want to go to your crop and shape. And here for this demo, let's go ahead and choose, let's go with the circle. I'll just use that one. It's easy, but any size will work. For this, I like the circle because I think it contrasts well with this example that I'm about to share. And now what I'm going to do here is resize that crop. And what I'm really trying to do is make sure that some of the runner, her hand, her arm, or her leg is outside of that circle. I might get a little bit of her head there, kind of center it around there, and then click on OK. And you'll be wondering, well, Claudio, I can't see the rest of the runner, but that's okay. That's where this second picture comes in handy here. So now with this second picture, we'll click on remove background, and Adobe Sensei, the artificial intelligence, will remove that background, and it looks right, almost right on spot there. And I'll go ahead and click on okay. And now we have the runner, and you can see there's a little bit of double happening there. I'll go ahead and use my command plus sign to zoom in. You could also use the zoom in feature here at the top. This just allows me to see much better. And with that top layer selected, I'm going to just use the arrow keys to fine tune the cutout there. And I think I pretty much got it spot on. There is a little bleeding here, which you can fix by going back to edit cutout, and you can zoom in much more. So let's get a little closer here, and you can really get into, I would say, the weeds in a sense here, but you can go through here and cut out a little bit of that yellow, and then I'll click okay. There's a little bit that shows on the hand, but that's fine. And I'll go ahead and zoom back out, and there it goes. It's pretty good right there. So now get it to view here, and then what I'll do here, do something pretty cool, is I can add an outline if I want to that circle by just adding a shape in the background. So let's go ahead and type in circle, and let's see how that looks like. I may or may not like it, but we'll see. Make sure that that circle is close, overlaid there. Make it slightly bigger than the other circle. And let's see what that looks like. I'll change this to black just so it matches with that outfit and the yellow there, kind of like a killer bee look here. There we go. Move it in the layers here, and I'll fine tune it with my keys. It actually looks pretty cool. I like that. And one extra that I'll share with you here that you could do with this is add some text. So I'll click on add text, and up here I'll go ahead and type in runner. For lack of creativity, I'll just use the word runner. So let's go ahead and resize that. So what I'll do is add that word runner here, And so there it is, right about there. And because it's black, it just seems to blend in. So try to use something that goes well. Look, it says suggested, so let's see what that looks like. Okay, not bad. We'll go with that. And then maybe make it a little brighter. There we go. Just slightly brighter just by moving that color dot right there. And then what I'll do is click on the word runner and move it behind the runner. And there we go. So now we have, you know, runner. Pretty cool. You can do that, or again, just do the runner there. And then if you want to, or I should say I suggest, is to select those and group it. So that way when you move or resize, it'll go all together. And that's how you can create these special cutout crops in Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this video, feel free to drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, like, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please, please share this video with your friends. Thanks so much for stopping by, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.